In this video, we are going to discuss about the Corvus OS Android 12. Alright, so let's start with the video, and first thing first, let me show you some features and why you should flash the Corvus OS. So in this, you can see that here you are getting a lot of customizations, and guys, as we know by the Corvus OS history that it is known for its better performance, for its gaming performance. I personally have used a lot of Corvus OS, like in the Android 11 segment, I have dedicated literally a whole amount of time on the Corvus OS itself. Like when I was playing BGMI, I did my Ace Master and all, so I did it on the Corvus OS. But guys, that was on Android 11, and in this video, we are going to flash the Android 12 segment, okay? So guys, if you are new to the video, then make sure that you hit that subscribe button. And guys, here you can see that there are various themes and all, various customizations which you can do. So you can see that in the theme segment, you can do various customizations. Now guys, many of you have already used the Corvus OS, so you might know that what are the various customizations which offer. So yeah, I mean, these are the customizations. You can read about all these, and even you can also flash in your device, and then you can simply take the enjoy all these customizations and all. Okay, now guys, let's talk about the Corvus OS. So guys, to be very honest, I mean super honest, I have not flashed this Corvus OS yet on my device, on my Redmi Note 8 Pro, because I remembered that when it was newly released, so I have flashed at that point of time. Okay, but again, I was using at that time the Corvus OS 14.4. okay, and when I have to flash this one, the 2.1, so I flashed it, and I did not expect the performance. I thought that performance will be good, but definitely there was some laggy UI. But again, guys, in since due to the heavy demand of the video, I'm making the video. So guys, let's see that how to flash this the Corvus OS. And guys, if you have any doubt, then guys, make sure that you hit make sure that you join the telegram group, and also guys, hit that subscribe button. So guys, let's start the video. So guys, now let's talk about that who all can flash this ROM. Okay guys, so currently this is my Redmi Note 8 Pro, and I'm going to flash in this one. So guys, currently let me tell you that I am on Pixel Experience Plus ROM, okay? And if you are on the same, or even if you are on a Cherish OS, or if you are on any Android 12 ROM, 12 or 12L ROM, then you are eligible to flash this Corvus OS. Okay, and let me show you that this is Android 12, and you can see that Pixel Experience Plus Begonia, and this is using Potato Kernel anyways. So guys, I was telling that I am on Android 12, okay, and if you are on any other Android 12 ROM, let it be Cherish OS, let it be Pixel Experience, let it be any of the Android 12 ROM, so you can flash this ROM, the Corvus OS. So this was the second segment. Now let's move to the third segment. So guys, what you have to do is you have to take this phone to the fast boot mode, to the recovery. Okay, now guys, many a times I was getting comments that guys, my device is not detected and all, so many people were commenting. So guys, for those whose device are not getting detected, so bro, what I am saying is that you connect your device right now in when it is in the power on situation, and copy the file, okay, and copy the file. Don't think that no, you have to go to the TWRP and then copy. No, it is not necessary, bro. You can copy your file directly when you are when your phone is on, okay. Now I will copy the file in the TWRP. You can copy right now as well when the phone is on. There is no need that you will copy it in TWRP. There is no hard and fast rule, okay. So let's go to the TWRP, press the power button, click on restart, and then press the volume up button continuously when the phone's device is restarting. Okay guys, so my device is rebooted. Now let's see which recovery is installed. Alright, so you can see guys that I have my Pixel Experience recovery which is installed over here. So guys, let's see. So guys, since my Pixel Experience recovery is installed, so what I have to do is I have to take this recovery to the TWRP recovery, because without that we cannot format the data. So let's take this recovery to the TWRP recovery. But guys, before taking it to the TWRP recovery, let me give you all the files which are required to flash the Corvus OS version 2.1. Okay, so let me go to my PC. Okay guys, so I am here on my PC, and here guys, you will require basically total 3 files. The first one is the TWRP recovery file, then second one is our ROM which is Corvus version 2.1, and the third file which you will require will be this firmware ROSS plus BRP 3.1. Now guys, I am saying that this third file you required because you are shifting from one custom ROM to another custom ROM, as I am on Pixel Experience Plus right now. So I have to switch from Pixel Experience Plus to the Corvus version, Corvus 2.1. So in that case, we are required this file. If you are flashing from any MIUI, then you don't require this. Now in this video, we are not talking about the MIUI. We are talking about how we can flash from Pixel Experience Plus to the Corvus OS. So we will be talking about, we will be requiring this file. Okay. So first file which you need is this one, this TWRP recovery file. And again, one thing to note here, guys, if you are on TWRP recovery, then you don't need, I will attach a photo over here and you will see that which is Pixel recovery and which is TWRP, okay? So guys, if you are on a TWRP recovery, then you don't need this recovery file, need this BRP 3.6 passport file. But if you are on a Pixel Experience recovery file, then you will certainly need this file. Okay, so what first step which we have to do is we have to select this recovery file, and again we have to extract it to BRP version 3.6. So when you will click on extract, you will get a folder like this. This folder will be formed, and again you have to double click this folder. Here you can see that three files. Basically you will get two files, this BRP MIUI and then BRP custom ROM. Here you have to select BRP MIUI Android 11 and double click this. Okay, now let's connect our device. Okay guys, so I am on my phone and here you can see that I am connecting on Pixel Experience recovery. Now let's flash the TWRP recovery. So how I will connect our my device, I will connect by the adapter cable, okay? So let's connect this. Okay, now let's connect this to our PC. So guys, let's connect this. But guys, before connecting it, one thing to keep in mind that you have to go to here advance, and here we have to reboot to the bootloader. Okay, so guys, when you have rebooted to your bootloader in the fast boot mode, so now we are good to go and we can connect our this one. Okay guys, so you can see that my recovery has been flashed and it has, my device, the Redmi Note 8 Pro has booted to my recovery. Okay, so here we are in our recovery, guys. Now let's copy the file. Guys, once again I am saying that if you are facing any error here, like if you are facing any code error, like a random letter or random word has been written here, so guys, in that case you just see this kernel video. There you will get to see that how to encrypt that data. Basically guys, that is an encrypted data, the first thing. The second thing is that guys, if you are facing an error that your phone is not showing while connecting to TWRP recovery, so guys, just do one thing, that boot your device to the system, and then in that case you will be able to see your phone and then you can copy the data, okay? Okay guys, so we have copied the ROM and this firmware file in our Redmi Note 8 Pro. You can see in the internal storage here. Okay, now ignore this ANX camera. I tried to install this one and I'll bring a video very soon on this thing. So yeah, I mean, we have copied the ROM and the firmware files. So yes, now let's move to our phone, and currently as of now our PC work is done. Okay guys, so let's see our phone. The file has been copied here and let's refocus. Okay, now we'll swipe to unlock over here and you can see, let's check that our file has been copied or not. So you can see that Corvus version 2.1 and the firmware, which is ROSS, has been successfully copied. Okay, now we have to come here to the mount. We have to mount the system vendor. Okay, now you don't have to do anything with this MTP part. Just mount system and vendor, press the home button, come to wipe, advanced wipe, Dalvik system vendor data and catch, swipe it to wipe it. Okay, now let's come to the install part, and here first thing which you will flash is this firmware. Okay, so select this, swipe to flash. Alright, now press back over here and select this Corvus version 2.1 and swipe to flash. Okay guys, so our flashing is successful. Now come press the home button and again mount the system and vendor. We don't have to do anything with this MTP again. I'm saying just mount the system and vendor. Again, come here to the wipe. Now click on format data, type Y, E and yes. Okay, so our data has been formatted. Now one thing to tell you guys, select disable force encrypt over here and swipe to flash. Now guys, don't ask me much questions, just flash this thing. The reason I'm saying is that if you don't flash this, then again when you will come to the TWRP recovery, when you will click on install, so you will see that there will be a asterisk or a random letters over here. And guys, again you will comment on the Telegram group, bro, I am getting this random letter error and all. So again, I have to recommend that kernel video. So that is the reason why I am saying do it in advance. Come to the set, come to the advance over here, click on disable force encrypt, swipe to flash. Again, if you want to root it, click on install magisk, swipe to flash. If you don't want to root it, just skip this step. Now I am not going to root this, so I am skipping this step. Press back over here. Now click on wipe, click on format data again, and here yes is already written. Just press tick. Okay, now let's reboot to our Corvus OS. Okay guys, so here we are in our Corvus OS version 2.1, which is Gamerspace. No, not this. This was not Gamerspace, but this is Revolt. Okay, so version 2.1 Revolt. Let's set up the offline. You can set up online as well. There is no restrictions. Click on next. Then scroll down here. Untick this too. The allow scanning and send users diagnostic. Click on accept. Select any of them. Click on skip. Okay guys, so here we are in our Corvus version 2.1, which is Revolt version. So let me show you guys and let's see what kernel does it use. So let's go to the about 4 over here, and you can see that Redmi Note 8 Pro, again Android 12 is used, and it is using the perf kernel, which is the Tutti kernel. Anyways guys, so it is using a perf kernel. We'll make sure that we change the kernel and let's test our performance again. Anyways, so this was about the flashing video guys. So if you like the video, then give it a like. And just guys, if you have any doubt regarding this ROM or any of the custom ROM, then you can join our Telegram group. Link is given in the description and comment section as well. So if you have any doubts, you can ask over there. Then if you have any doubt regarding this ROM, you can also ask it over there. And do comment if you have any doubt regarding the flashing steps and all. Anyways, so guys, here are some features that it comes YouTube by default. Then Viper for Android is also given by default. Here you will get the MIUI camera. Guys, so many of you were demanding that, bro, I want MIUI camera. So you can just flash from Pixel Experience Plus to this ROM and you can get this MIUI camera. Okay, so you can see that you are getting MIUI options. I don't know whether why it is crashing. Okay, now it is not crashing. So you can see that there are lots and lots of options over here. Portrait is not supported. I know that thing very well. And you can see that these are the options. So guys, more I'll talk in the review video. And this is how the recent tab opens. And here you can see the ROM and all. Now this is for the Google Lens. This is for cross cutting. This one for closing all. This is for screenshot. Okay. So yeah guys, this was about in the flashing of the Corvus 2.1. This is definitely a feature loaded ROM. So if you want to try, go ahead and flash this ROM. Make sure you give it a try, because this will definitely not disappoint you. This is better than the Pixel Experience Plus out there. I can say at least that much. Alright, so yeah, this was about in this video. Make sure that you subscribe to our channel and hit that like button. So till then, take care.